How's it going, guys? Back for two. Fast forward to last week. One that's not golf course shoes would imply a certain level of underlying distress, which I didn't pick up paying attention to. I just dove face first into a shithole that I should have stayed out of. Because as I continued responding and interacting with this person, the conversation keeps escalating into a direction that has nothing at all to do with what the notification is about. What he's trying to get accomplished. It's merely just a dick swinging contest, finger pointing contest, wave game. This person to feel obligated to approach slander. And I guess the request came off as an insult to them, or as some sort of method of neglecting her child, which is also my child. But that I'm still trying to remember. I think a lot of the major issues in this are because of substance abuse. I think there is an underlying emotional turmoil going on with that person that honestly makes me feel sorry for them. Lash out for no reason. People have reasons behind this type of behavior. It's very rare that they will actually be honest and tell you what they're going through. You don't even know, and I don't have the patience to dig. Because, you know, in order for you to want to be there for someone, as you know, a friend, for some time, some kind of support in that situation, you have to be dealing with the person who's at least being honest with themselves about the issue. Not trying to blame the issue on somebody else has nothing to do with it. I can't help but think that if her major struggle is because of the fact that I have given her a child, is giving the custody of that child such a impossible option that would get rid of everyone she wanted. And then, you know, I am a son of a given parent. I am an adult, so I want to figure out a way to really take care of my child and I'm going to neglect them. Something what bothers me the most is that I don't even have to deal with this person for the rest of the time. I have such little patience left for this person. Not to mention, and this is introverts, not to mention the fact that I'm already literally, not figuratively, literally had to defend my house by shooting this person with a gun twice. Not figuratively, literally, had to shoot this person twice. So that is like a huge issue that I still have to deal with. Like, I don't know, like, I don't know how much more I can do to show her seriousness about protecting my household. But just recently, this was like yesterday, this person is still Children that I have, cutting ties with one, maybe what needs to be done to protect and nurture this. Because if I've signed my rights away and just paid for my new to me either. This is not, it's not cool. I don't think I've matured out of it. I just don't think they have. I know they have, because people that have don't know that. But at the end of the day, you know, I can't raise adults. I'm not in the business of raising adults. I have enough trouble trying to maintain my own situation and prove it like that. But pretty much is what it is at this point, because, you know, they have drew their line in the sand and so have I. Now we're back at Wild Wild West. And I'm trying to figure out if, like, if I should go the legal route with, like, protective orders because of these threats, or if I should just give them some more rounds to hold on to. Maybe I'll figure it out then, but probably not. Who knows? Probably just sleep on it some more, you know. I'm not really, I'm not worried about it at all. It just upsets me because it's like I don't want to have to deal with a bunch of hostility trying to raise a child. Like, it's hard enough to deal with a child's personality, let alone a immature adult. Like, and it's like, I can't say that this person has to feel that way towards me, because I've honestly gone out of my way to not let them deal with me, to not let them have to interact with me whatsoever. You see how that's worked. But I cannot sit and complain like this just happened to me out of nowhere. There once was a time when I wish I would have made different choices. You know? That's where a lot of this stuff stems from. The choices I've made that I deeply regret. And I'm a would say having a child with that person is probably the biggest regret I've ever had in my life. And, but, you know, I can't live with regret forever, and assume to be happy, or assume to find what I would consider peace or joy. Regret is going to only cause me more stress and depression, turmoil that I don't need. Pretty much going to make me more like the person that I'm dealing with, which I just can't allow. What the fuck? What? Yo ho ho. Sorry guys, I'm just over here being watched like a freaking anyway. Yeah, so that's one of the situations. The other situation is similar but different, and it annoys me just as much. It's just a headache either way, but something that I gotta do. And the thing that really bugs me the most is I know there's a lesson. And I know there's a lesson to be learned. I just cannot, for the life of me, figure out what it is. You know, I don't know if it's stop dealing with people that are sick in the head, or stop having kids, or stop associating myself with these people, or what, but. This is getting more and more exhausting. Maybe that's the message. To stop being so lazy when it comes to understanding and communicating. But I don't think it's... I'm not going to say what I think because I have a thought right from the beginning. But, honestly, I just need to... I'm just going to keep praying about it, asking God to make things more peaceful, give me more days like today where I'm not disturbed by these personalities and perspectives, you know, I can actually think straight. Hope that, like, over time we can learn to co-parent somehow. I mean, I don't think there's really much hope left in that being a possibility, but I gotta stay optimistic, not for myself, but for my little pups. Because I do love them a lot. Another thing that bothers me a lot about these situations is that it always comes down to the caliber of parent I am and not what I'm trying to be. That shit cuts you deep. Cuts you real deep. Especially when it comes from the person you're parenting with, you know, it's like one person that you're always trying to build up and say, "Hey, man, you're doing a great job. I'm proud of you, man. You've always sucked. It's like, thanks, thanks. And then, you know, you look at your kids and you're like, sure they brainwash you too into believing that I suck. Well, my question a lot of the times to that is, you know, why do you want me to help you raise this child I'm just going to teach them how to suck? What is the point? Why can't you just leave me out of it? Turn them into whoever you want them to be. Instead of worrying about me, turn them into a piece of shit like I am. Maybe I just have this negative attitude, victimized mentality. It's never going to get me anywhere. Maybe, you know, I just am trying to be something that I'm not. Maybe there's no father in me, and I'm just trying to act like I know what I'm doing. It's hard to say. It's hard to say. But I know one thing. I walk in the room and they say my name and they join me in my arms and they hug me and tell me they miss me and they love me. I can feel that. I feel that shit. That shit in a place that takes away all that pain. Makes me really happy to have them. Sometimes I wonder if it would have been different if I would have just had them all with one person. I know it would have been different. I know I wouldn't have got all the beautiful babies that I have if I did. Not the way it is. I have to accept that. Regardless of what I want, you know, I have to make the best of what I have, like I've always been taught. That's what I'm gonna do. But I'm gonna go ahead and get in this house for unless he calls the police on me and getting something out here. Talking to some girl or something. And I will tune back in with you guys tomorrow morning. I'll probably do two more videos tomorrow morning. As always, thanks for watching. Episode 187. Adios.